In this video, I demonstrate the different shades of green that you can mix from yellow and black. I use 5 different shades of yellow and 2 different kinds of blacks. I also discuss the color theory behind why yellow and black turns green. If you ever tried to darken yellow by adding black to it, you may have been surprised that it turns green. A lot of people will explain that this is because there's impurities in the black pigments or it's biased towards blue. I actually think that dark yellow does have a green tint to it. And at the end of the video, I demonstrate why I think that is, or I conduct some experiments to prove this. This is Liquitex Cadmium Yellow Light. So here it is, pure strength. And if you add a little bit of black, this is carbon black. It starts to go a little bit greenish. Cadmium yellow is fairly opaque, and I think the opaque colors work well to make green. So add a little bit more black to it. The green that yellow and black makes is more muted than if you mixed yellow and blue, so it does work in landscapes. This is a dark green. I'll do one more step of just the pure black, or very close to being pure black. So cadmiums are considered to be toxic. If you're looking for an alternative, I use Hansa Yellow Opaque, and this is what it looks like straight from the tube. It's a bit more orange than the cad yellow light, but it still will work to make green. So if I add a little bit of carbon black to it, it does turn green. So if I add a little bit more black to this, now that starts to look more green than the first step. And a bit more. It's a fairly decent dark green. And this is almost pure black. This is cadmium yellow medium. It's the Liquitex soft body acrylics. I think it's slightly more orange than the Hansa Yellow Opaque. So here it is straight from the tube. It definitely is more orange. I don't know if it shows up that way in the video, but now the yellows that are more orange, when you mix them with black, it does go green, but it's kind of like a brownish green. We'll see what happens. It's probably a little bit too much. Add a little bit more black. I'll do one more step. I thought I'd try this out too. Diarylide Yellow from Golden. And it's pretty similar to the Cad Yellow Medium, although I think it's probably more orange, so we'll see what happens. Add a little bit more black. I think what happens is the more red there is in there, the more brown the color will go. I mean, you might call that green, but it's not as green as the other yellows. I could see this being used in a landscape where you would have these muted greens and then maybe a little bit of like orange, especially like fall foliage. So the last yellow I have here is yellow ochre. So here's a little bit of black mixed into the yellow ochre. To me, it looks brown. If I add some more black, it just makes it darker. Compared to the other colors, I really don't see as much as a green shift. I know people use it in a limited palette. There's the Zorn palette. I suppose you could try to use this as a green. But to me, it looks brownish. You may be wondering if you would get the same results by using a different black. So I used Mars black in place of the carbon black, and the results were pretty much the same. The most common explanation for why yellow and black makes green is that the black is biased towards blue. While some black pigments are on the cool side, I don't think that's the full explanation. I actually think that dark yellow has a green tint to it. What color is dark yellow? Here's a tape dispenser in a pure yellow background. The shadow is a dark muted green color, which is created by lowering the intensity of the light. It has nothing to do with the pigments. This is the shadow color by itself, and here are the greens I mixed from the yellow and black. They're similar, especially the green I mixed from cadmium yellow medium. Another experiment that you can do is open up a color picker. This is the one that's found in Photoshop. I created a pure yellow, and then I just darkened it. It also produces a dark olive green, and that has nothing to do with pigments. It's made purely from light. So if you're painting a yellow shadow, keep in mind that it will be slightly green. If it's too green, you can add a small touch of red to it to neutralize it slightly. If you like this video, you may be interested in watching the videos in my color theory playlist. Thanks for watching, and please remember to subscribe.